The Congregation of Missionary Sisters of Mary Help of Christians.
Padre Fernando, it's arriving. Come, let's go and meet them. Welcome, Padre Fernando.
Thank you, Mother.
Here we have Padre Fernando and eight novices who came all the way from Italy to carry out the mission of our Lord Jesus Christ to our beloved Assam land.
The first indigenous congregation in Northeast India was founded on October 24, 1942 at Guwahati, Assam by His Excellency Stephen Ferrando, SDB, the then Bishop of Shillong. The congregation has six provinces in India and a delegation in Italy and Africa. The provincial headquarters are at Bangalore, Guwahati, Kolkata, Shillong, Tinsukia, and Tezpur, and the delegation headquarters is at Turin, Italy. It has over 1,500 members belonging to 60 ethnic groups working in 190 centers in India and 25 in other countries. The province of Mary Help of Christians Shillong was canonically erected on 13 February 1988 with its headquarters at St. Margaret's Convent, Peachlands, Shillong. From its inception, the province grew rapidly under the dynamic leadership of Sister Teresa Varkey, Sister Mildred Pedi, Sister Christiana Munson, Sister Elizabeth Pakumala, Sister Maristella Umdor, Sister Catherine Joseph, Sister Mary Concepta Dakar, and at present by Sister Maria Goretti T. Sangma. The province is privileged to have its headquarters at Peachlands, where the mortal remains of the congregation's founder, Venerable Stephen Ferrando, is laid. He desired greatly to be buried in the soil of Kasipanar, a land he loved dearly, where he spent most of his life as a bishop of Shillong for 35 years. Fulfilling his wish, his mortal remains was brought from Italy to Shillong on 3rd December 1987 and was interred in St. Margaret's Convent Chapel on December 12, 1987. Today, hundreds of people visit the tomb and seek his intercession. Stephen Ferrando was born on 28 September 1895 at Rosiglian in the province of Genova, Italy, as the second of the three children of Mrs. Josephine Salvi and Mr. Augustine Ferrando. Born and brought up in pious and hard-working middle-class family, Stephen Ferrando acquired those traits in his life. He said, "From my family I received a rich heritage, a great love for God and Madonna, spirit of sacrifice, and a temperament inclined for joy."
To mark the 125th birth anniversary of our founder, Venerable Stephen Ferrando, Mary Help of Christians Province, Shillong, which is the mother house of the congregation. And the mortal remains of our founder is laid. Feels privileged and honored to bring out this documentary. And more important thing is to render him a fitting tribute on this important year of his birth.
Being true to the vision and mission of our founder and the congregation, the province undertakes village tour, family visit, and catechetical instruction in all its centers. It also carries out apostolate of education, healing ministry, boarding houses, health centers, vocational training centers, and supports the domestic workers through the domestic workers movement. The province has over 230 members and 32 centers spread across five dioceses located in the states of Meghalaya, Mizoram, and Kerala. Presenting here our communities and the activities we carry out in these centers. Little Flower Convent, Malki, was established in the year 1962 by Bishop Stephen Ferrando. Officially, the community was instituted on 21st January 1962.
First of all, he liked this place very much because this has got some resemblance of Rosalione. Secondly, he wanted also his daughters to go for higher studies and they needed a place to stay. And that is another thing. Most important reason is he loved the people of Malki. They were very poor, ignorant, illiterate, and with a superstitious belief and so on. He wanted his daughters to do something to change their status of life.
Little Flower Convent is a formation house for girls who are considering to dedicate their lives to God on the congregation of MSMHC. It also has a boarding which caters to the girls of far-flung villages. Down through the ages, Little Flower Malki becomes a shining beacon on the top of the mountain for the redemption of many children and people of the surrounding area. St. Margaret's Convent. Nestled at the heart of the city of Shillong, St. Margaret's Peachlands is the mother house of the congregation and a hallowed dwelling place of the mortal remains of our founder. It was established on 15th August 1963. Peachlands functions as an important house of the province. The sisters are engaged in the apostolate of education, family visits, and involve themselves in parish activities.
Leave your home and your country. Serve to spread to the poor and needy.
It has been a formation house for the aspirants who are studying in higher secondary. It also functions as a study house for the sisters attending regular classes in various colleges. St. Margaret's Higher Secondary School is staffed with a total of 2,200 students and 70 teaching and non-teaching staff. It has a prestigious status as one of the best schools in the state with its good academic performance, quality education with a firm moral ground. St. Joseph's Dispensary, Jiao Lansona Lin, was established on 23rd April 1975. At present, Sister Elizabeth Villapalil is in charge of the dispensary and serves the needs of the patient from the surrounding area. Sisters here also make hose that is supplied to many parishes in the province. Resurrection Convent, Bunursla. Soaked Marked with a missionary zeal, the MSMHC continued delving deeper into the mission of evangelization, exploring new areas and people. Tireless evangelization work is going on in the field of missionary evangelization and education. Mary Immaculate Novitiate Mauro enjoys a perfect milieu of isolation and tranquility amidst shading pine trees away from the heart of the city and its noise. It has been the house of prayers. It was established in 1981 with the sole purpose of setting up a novitiate. The first batch of novices at the center was 38 in number. At the moment, there are 34 novices from different parts of India during their canonical year of novitiate. Stephen Memorial Convent, Maulai, Mauro. Another significant milestone bedecked the growth of MSMHC with the opening of Stephen Memorial Convent at Mauro Maulai on 15 February 1986. Besides the apostolate of education and boarding, the center expands its mission to part-time touring, and oratory is the highlight of every Sunday's program.
I remember Chiprando was a speaker for his tall and big Padman, I don't know. Then he's very good to people, and he just learned to work. If your work is there, so he leave the work and attend the people. Yeah, everyone who can go to Bishop's house, I remember when you want to go, you used to go. So Bishop Randu, really I can say he's a good and kind father, not only as bishop, as good a father for people.
Holy Family Convent, Maulong. With its inherent missionary charism and spirit, the MSMHC ventured into frontier mission at Maulong in the year 1995 with four pioneering members. St. Ursula School, run by the Catholic community of Maulong since 1932, has been taken up by the sisters ever since then. It has been upgraded from Class 6 to higher secondary by the sisters. Presently, sisters are engaged in various apostolates such as missionary evangelization, education, healing ministry, boarding and family visits. The convent is a sheltering home to boarders from far-flung villages. Besides catering services to the Khasi, a vast number of Garo immigrants from Bangladesh are reached out by the sisters.
Ferrando Convent, Lycra, Maudrong.
The MHMSC keeps sailing with unquenchable desire to conquer the world with Christ's love. A significant event was witnessed in its journey on 2006 as it embraced a mission center at Maudrong in association with Salesian Fathers. The new convent was blessed and inaugurated on 21st June 2008. The unflagging zeal and dedication the sisters contribute to the growth of the church and society, imparting knowledge and faith through various apostolates such as missionary evangelization, education, family visits, and boarding. While sowing the seeds of faith, the sisters continue to nurture the faith that was planted through various formative activities in different villages. The wheel of time spun out of momentous event with the establishment of Ferrando Transit Shelter Home, Mauro, on 20th December 2008. The center is child-friendly, which caters to the needs of poor and vulnerable children as well as women in domestic work. Adding a new page in the chronicle of the province, it paved the way for the concrete and effective realization of the heart of the founder, that beat for poor children. As he wrote in his letters, work for the poor children. Take special care of the poor and needy children. Tucked amidst elegant pine trees, the center becomes a safe haven, a home away from home for children and women at the periphery of the society. Veranda Transit Shelter Home also gives vocational training to the women from surrounding areas to help them in their livelihood.
Veranda Transit Shelter Home, Kum Children's Home, is a home away from home. It was the plight of the women, girls, and children that motivated Bishop Stephen Veranda to found a congregation of the Missionary Sisters of Mary Help of Christians in 1942. Bishop Veranda often writes to the sisters, telling to take care of the poor children. Take special care of the poor and the needy children and women. Therefore, it does the commendable job through the Northeastern Regional Domestic Workers Movement to find a place in this area here and construct a building in order to take care of the poor and the needy children and women.
St. Thomas Convent, Myrung. The congregation has been walking the extra mile to be true to its call of being a missionary. St. Thomas Convent, Myrung was established on 14th February 1973. The apostolates through which the sisters disseminate the good news are missionary evangelization, education, and boarding. The congregation also actively involves in small Christian communities or SCCs or basic ecclesial communities BECs to uplift the people of the parish in spirit and in deeds, where words become actions.
The congregation has taken up this small Christian communities very seriously. It is just maybe of the clear concept that small Christian communities just are a way of being church to each other, not just only for Sunday, but every day. So many changes have taken place in different parishes, different dioceses, after starting small Christian communities, especially among our sisters. But now I would like, you know, just to bring to five important points. So I could see there is so much of prayer, change in the life of people, and then the spirit of sharing in them, and then the spirit of mutual support for each other. And then, you know, small Christian communities, you know, is learning from each other. And then plus maybe the last point, that very important point is, it is always a mission-oriented community. It's not just ending in prayer, but reading the Word of God and prayer leading into action, especially to bring social transformation.
St. Xavier's Convent, Mausendam. The world's wettest place captured the gaze of the MSMHC, which was ever zealous and vibrant in sowing the seeds of faith. Hence, a new missionary venture was launched on 2 February 1977 at Mausendam with the sole aim of spreading the good news and building the church.
Dekat aduk mentah masih nak ayu ya kan dekat dispensary berkhamtam ni kau eh boleh kan bahula ayat lap dekat jumpli lap li lenti jumu bahasa sayo benman kah ni ringkat kamera kau berkuat berkhidmat berkhidmat.
Grace Villa, Barapani. Grace Villa is built on a little hillock in Umnyu Kwan in Umiam Lake, sharing boundaries with Bethel Retreat Center of MSMHC and the water edges of the Umiam Lake on the back side. This plot of land was bought in 2013 with the view of housing the elderly sisters of the province to give them more living space and better facilities to handle their aging days. The climate here is warmer and more pleasant. To cheer up elderly sisters and to keep their mood high, young aspirants accompany them in Grace Villa with different activities. The MSMHC embarked upon this new mission at Mokerwat Maulongweer area on 27th March 1977. The mission of Christ is continued through the apostolate of missionary evangelization, education, healing ministry, and boarding. The sisters work in collaboration with the diocesan fathers. Healing ministry through dispensary and free health camp focuses on the poor in the interior villages. The dedicated service of the sisters through various apostolates is a vivid reflection of God's love for His people.
Holy Spirit Convent, Songsak, Kasia.
Determined to continue on the footsteps of founder who traveled through the forests, hills, and valleys, crossing rivers, walking miles on rough patches to spread the good news, the MSMHC listened to the call of the mission in a remote village of Songsak, Kasia. The convent was established on 18th February 1992 with three pioneering sisters, specifically as a concrete realization of our founder's concern for the poor, women, and children in far-off villages.
Queen Mary Convent, Shillong, West Kasi Hills.
In its continuous strive to scatter the seeds of faith and good news, the MSMHC crosses all barriers and boundaries to extend its services to far-off places. Thus, Queen Mary Convent was established on 24 February 1995. Great works have been established through the apostolates of missionary evangelization, education, healing ministry, and boarding. At present, the community is formed by six sisters and there are boarders.
Presentation Convent, Nonghalam.
The MSMHC trod the road less traveled in the year 1993 as the new mission center was established in this remotest part of West Kasi Hills on 15th May. Isolated by a river and geographical distance as well as lack of proper means of transportation and communication, Nonghalam remains a challenging destiny for the determined MSMHCs. The mission in Nonghalam is a realization of a part of the project and vision to undertake a challenging and difficult mission as a mark of the Golden Jubilee of the congregation. Today, present convent continues to cater mainly to the areas of Lingam, Garo, Kasi, and Nepalese. One sister is fully dedicated to healing ministry through dispensary while two sisters work in collaboration with the Claritian Fathers. The work of missionary evangelization is thriving with two sisters fully engaged in it in and out of season.
Ferrando Convent, Maurusiar.
Basking in God's favor, every inch of the journey and new venture takes the MSMHC towards realization of its vision. The year 2008 opened the door to a fresh start at Maurusiar village in the parish of Divine Savior, Nonban Nongstoin Diocese. Education as the main apostolate aims at the wholesome development and upliftment of the simple villagers.
Holy Family Convent, Kliriat.
Resembling the heart of Jesus, the Good Shepherd reaching out for his sheep, the MSMHC established themselves at Kliriat from the year 1978 with the mission to draw people to the Kingdom of God. The sisters go out to villages, visit families, preach the Word of God, and assist the people in the journey of faith. As the fruits of such endeavors can be seen from the number of young girls who are aspiring to join the congregation. At the present, we have 17 aspirants pursuing to become nun to serve in the field of God.
St. Theresa's Convent, Murulang, Jowai.
Scripting on a new story on 24 January 1983 by embarking upon a new mission at Muralang Jowai, the MSMHC widened its horizon in the hills of the Jaintias. The first batch of missionaries set the footing for the work of evangelization, which is being zealously continued to the present. Hands on the plow through the apostolate of missionary evangelization, education, and boarding, the sisters continue to serve the people from the start till today. Sowing the seeds of faith as they go along, the sisters manifest tremendous zeal for the spread of the good news.
About our founders, simplicity and humility, I want to say something. He was very fond of the poor and the needy. I used to go every Saturday to stitch his own clothes, and there I saw there was no tablecloth on his table, no cushion on his chair. Well, I watched as I was stitching his clothes. I used to have one eye to his office. And when poor people used to come, they used to bring for him chickens, vegetables, and other gifts. And our bishop used to get up from his seat to welcome the people from the door. And whatever things he used to get, he used to keep it on the table. And that is why fathers, they never use the tablecloth. And I understood that. And that I admired his simplicity, his love for Mother Mary, his love for the poor and the needy.
Ferrando Convent, Bundihati.
The MSMHC carved out its presence at Bundihati with a humble beginning on 19 February 2002, with the opening of class nursery and KG using the basement of the church as classrooms. The convent at Bundihati, which falls under Holy Family Parish Cleriat of Jowai Diocese, was solemnly blessed on 30 June 2003. It was a provincial house for Bundihati Province for 2 years under the leadership of late Sister Mary George until the amalgamation with Shillong Province in 2004. The current strength of the school consists of 460 students from class nursery to class 10, with 13 teachers and 4 sisters. The crux of the presence of MSMHC is evangelization and faith formation through the apostolate of education and family visit. In their free time, sisters take keen interest in learning new skills.
St. Joseph's Convent, Yongkalu.
A lovely village tucked amidst charming hills and lush greenery, Yongkalu is a sub-center of Good Shepherd Parish, Lat Rumbai, with majority of its populace following the Catholic faith. On 29 January 2004, an official inaugural function was held in the presence of religious dignitaries and laity. Life in the village took a new turn with the entry of the MSMHC. An onward march in the field of education and faith formation has brought great changes and progress. The YAC members are active in the village and they're constantly working with the sisters hand in hand.
It was the GC6 that was held in 2000. The general chapter members got inspirations to start this movement. It was named as Young Apostles of Christ, following the motto of our beloved father and founder, Bishop Stephen Ferrando, whose motto is Apostle of Christ. It is very successful in the sense that when we began in the beginning, we had only few members. But when the parents see that the improvement in the lifestyle of the children, the faith formation that has taken place and the leadership that they learned from this movement. So it was very much appreciable and very much fruitful. So much so that these children are the one who go from house to house and try to get their friends, their peer group, one-to-one information, and then in that way one-to-one meeting, and they attract many of these young boys and young girls to the church.
St. Paul's Convent, Jalaphat.
There is never an end of the horizon for the MSMHC in the pursuit of its charism and goal. Jalaphat is a village in the countryside away from the busy din of the town. Majority of its inhabitants are yet to know Christ. The year 2008 saw the new missionary expedition as the first batch of sisters reached Jalaphat on 30th March. They stayed in a rented house until the inauguration of the new convent on 16th August 2009. Apart from running two village schools, Khasi and English section, the sisters give special thrust to building faith through house visits, catechetical instructions, therefore bringing the good news to the people.
Good Shepherd Convent, Latrumbai.
The dawn of 11th April 2010 unfolded a new page in the history of the province as a new center at Latrumbai began. The official inauguration was held on 18th April 2010. The life of the sisters in this mission station is a vivid picture of a missionary who, unfazed by hardships, strives to build God's kingdom. The main apostolate is education, and focus is given to impart faith through catechism, and the sisters reach out to people through family visits. Occasionally, sisters find times for recreation and play some games together when the weather is bad. In the year 1983 marked the birth of the MSMHC in the soil of Mizoram, as it stepped its first foot at Champai on 27 January, from where the MSMHC spread its wings to various places in the state in the later years.
St. Mary's Convent, Champai.
Situated in a strategically important location at the Indo-Myanmar border, Champai is surrounded by lush green hills and a panoramic view of beautiful agricultural flatlands which offer a breathtaking sight. The key apostolates of the community are education, boarding, healing ministry, vocational training, and family visits.
St. Lawrence Convent, Ramtar.
At the foot of the city of Aizawl rests the locality of Ramtar. Though situated at the bottom fringe of the city, Ramtar gains its significance with the establishment of Catholic institution and the Bishop's House of Aizawl Diocese. The presence of St. Lawrence Convent has made positive impact on the society. Hence, the contributions of the sisters in the past and present have augmented towards the progress of the mission in this area.
Auxilium Convent, Siaha. Siaha is the capital and the headquarters of Mara Autonomous District Council.
To work in collaboration with the Salesian Fathers, the three pioneering sisters arrived at Siaha on 3 March 1995. The sisters involved themselves in the parish work besides teaching in school, fulfilling the charism through village tour, catechesis, family visits, faith formation with special thrust on women and children according to the mind of Our Father.
St. Mary's Convent, Siling.
A new chapter began in the history of the province with the establishment of a new convent at Siling on 3 February 1996 in collaboration with the Salesian Fathers. The sisters at present embark upon the apostolate of missionary evangelization, education, and boarding.
Ferrando Convent, Zemmerbach.
Ferrando Convent, Zemmerbach was officially inaugurated on 8 May 2003. Unruffled by inconveniences and lacks, the sisters rendered their commitment to give the best of education to children at the periphery, molding them to be a responsible citizen, reassuring them that God is love. Only a number of 14 tiny tots in LKG laid the future foundation of the now most popular school of the locality with 440 students from LKG to class 9. Today, Ferrando High School functions with 23 teaching and non-teaching staff. The center is growing in both quality and quantity, scaling higher for the continuous realization of its goal. Magnificently facing the distant hills and fed by lucid air, Peace Home is a home that emanates peace, hope, and life. Ferrando Integrated Women Development Center, Peace Home is training come rehabilitation center for young girls and women in difficult circumstances. Inspired by the Gospel of John chapter 10, verse 10, that they may have life, life in abundance. The center envisions a society where displaced women are enhanced to uphold their rights and reclaim their rightful place and dignity. The official inauguration of FIWC Peace Home was held on 13th November 2006. The center offers integrated support to victims of substance abuse and HIV/AIDS, capacity building and livelihood development programs, to improve livelihood for underprivileged women, recovering drug users, alcoholics, sex workers, and HIV-infected and affected. The center functions with 5 sisters, 30 staff, 4 volunteers, and 40 link workers. The sisters render spiritual and material succor to the most vulnerable and dejected sections of the society.
Ferrando Convent, Long Thalai.
On 3rd April 2013, the pioneering sisters arrived at Long Thalai to begin a new center in collaboration with the Salesian Fathers. An official inaugural function and blessing of the Ferrando Convent was hosted on 20th June 2013 at Don Bosco School. At present, 2 sisters are engaged in the apostolate of education, family visits, and catechetical instruction. Sealed with a missionary zeal and enthusiasm, the pioneering sisters epitomize Christ's love as they tend the flock and preach the good news.
Ferrando Convent, Leng Pui.
Ferrando Convent, Leng Pui hostel for girls was canonically erected on May 31, 2018. The sisters collaborate with MFFS Fathers at SFS Schools and run Girls Hostel for the college students of St. Xavier's College Leng Pui, run by the Darjeeling Province of the Society of Jesus. Sisters are also engaged in the apostolate of family visits.
Ferrando Pavan, Parakulam. A felt need of the moment directed the gaze of the MSMHC beyond the boundary of the Northeast. This time, the arrow pointed to down south Kerala. On 25 April 1996, a new list of convent had been enlisted in the book of the MSMHC Shillong Province as Ferrando Pavan Parakulam was opened. The convent was primarily established to set up formation house for candidates from Kerala and take up pastoral work in the parish and run English medium school for the people of the area. The school is up to class 6 with 190 students. One sister is a full-time BCC coordinator in the diocese, and the sisters are also engaged in the pastoral work of the parish, contributing for its growth.
We, the sisters of Mary Help of Christians Province Shillong, inspired by the Word of God, guided by the Holy Spirit, through the intercession of Mary Help of Christians, who is the patroness of our province, we march ahead to proclaim the good news to the poor and marginalized, in particular to the women, girls, and children. Today, if our founder were to see us from above, he would be smiling at us because his daughters have reached out to 12 countries. And I feel privileged and honored to tell you, 16 of our sisters are overseas missionaries working in Hawaii, Germany, Italy, Myanmar, and Africa.
And there are those deep and fair and old.